Let us look at the book of Matthew, chapter 5. Verse 5. Matthew, chapter 5, verse 5. It says that, blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. So this is the Sermon on the Mount, and Jesus started about the blessing. What kind of people will be blessed in the kingdom of God? So the standard of kingdom of God and this world is different, right? It's we can say it's opposite way, or yeah, it's very different. So Jesus taught us what kind of people can be blessed in the kingdom of God. His meekness, yeah, it is the heart of Jesus. So let us read Matthew chapter 11, verse 29 also. Matthew chapter 11, verse 29. It says that, take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. So here, gentle, it can be also the same of meekness. Yeah. And then, Matthew chapter 21, verse 5. 21, verse 5. He says that, say to the daughter of Zion, behold, your king is coming to you, humble and mounted on the donkey, on a colt, a foal or beast of burden. Okay. So here then also, meekness and humble, it's somehow similar. Gentle, and then humbleness, meekness. So Jesus was coming to this world with this heart of meekness. Yeah. So firstly, we need to know the meaning. What is the meekness exactly? Like in the maybe dictionary, the English dictionary, then meekness is this kind of meaning, somehow calm, silent, and when there is some conflict, or if my opinion is different from others, then I don't try to fight, just be quiet and not using the violence. Yeah. So if someone is saying this, and then if my thinking is somehow different, then I don't talk. This kind of things, like English, with English, then somehow it's this kind of, not like strongly saying my opinion, so that I don't want to make any conflict. But then, is it really true meaning of meekness? If then is it good? We just be quiet and then not make any opinion. Even though I think that this, it's not very, very good, maybe. But then we just be quiet because Jesus said that meek person is blessed. There are, don't make any problem. I don't want to make any problem, so I will just be quiet. Is it really the meaning from the original word? So to know the meaning, then we need to maybe find the first meaning, original meaning of the first word, right? So if we look at the first, like the original word, in Greek language, it is prouts. Prouts, yeah. So what is it, the meaning of this? This is tame or submissive or strong control over someone's expression. So tame, something is tamed, then what is it? If we are taming some animal, if like a horse from a bush, from a wilderness, we like hold that kind of animal. And then if I want to raise it in my house, then how should we do? It should be tamed, right? If not, then it will go anyway, it will not come back. So something like that. So long time ago in Greece, when they are taming the wild horses, after they tamed, then it's really submissive. And then it's really like obeying the owner's will. And then the best horse is the horse for the battle, which is going to the battle. It does not like be maybe afraid. It's not like afraid of fighting, or it's not like shaken by the big sound, like or shouting or people's crying. And then it has that, courage to go and then used in the fighting. It's not like embarrassed by any situation, but it's very courageous. And then it's very submissive to the owner. It really like determined to obey the owner's will. So wherever the owner is taking that horse, then it's just going. And then it never shaken. So this kind of meaning, yeah. This is the original meaning of the meekness. So it is like it's a state of calm control and mastery that allows an imperishable, friendly kindness. Yeah. Yeah, so it's controlling itself, and then it's like not changing according to like the will of the owner, and then ever like kind. It's not like very violent, but then it's obeying, and then maybe trying to obey the will of the owner, and then yeah, that is the meekness. Yeah. So it's coming with this, this word, this is the word closely associated to the objective philos, meaning beloved or friend. Yeah, you know, philos, it is also the friendly love. Yeah. So it's also from similar word. Yeah. So Jesus was meek. Right? Jesus was meek as a lamb, yeah. But then it's not that he was weak, and then because of powerlessness, then he was just killed. It's not. But then with the strong control, and then he was obedience. He was in full control of his own destiny. So he decided to obey God's will. So if we read John chapter 10, Let us read John chapter 10, verse 18. Verse 17 and 18, I will read. For this reason, the Father loves me, because I lay down my life that I may take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I have authority to lay it down, and I have authority to take it up again. This charge I have received from my Father. Okay. So Jesus decided to go the way of cross. He determined by himself. It's not by the power of the world or someone pushed him to die on the cross, but then he himself determined to obey God's will. So here then we can see that he's like a strong control of himself to follow the will of God. Yeah. So even his destiny, he decided to obey God. Yeah. So it's not because of force, but then we ourselves can go the way to obey God. Yeah. And then also through it then I become somehow tamed to the will of God. Yeah. Yeah. So this is the kind of meaning. Yeah. If then it's not like the opposite way of courageous or fearful, maybe, or just be quiet. It's not like that, but it's like controlling himself. And it has the courage without the fear, but controlling himself. This is the meaning of the meekness. So, but then if we are like just soft, just quiet, then how can we fight, right? At the time of fighting, we need to fight at the fierce battle of spiritual war. But then if we are just soft and then weak, then this person cannot really win over the battle. Yeah. Also, when we are looking at Jesus, who was fighting against the evil things? Sometimes Jesus entered the temple, and then he made the whip, he was like turning the tables of money changers and chasing away the sellers of the lambs out to the temple. He was filled with that anger, It's not by his emotional anger, but then because of he knew the will of God, and then he was fighting against the evil things. So it's not just like Jesus was meek, but then sometimes he was very courageous, knowing that this can bring him the great danger, but then he was not fearful. He was not feared by that danger, but then he was facing that danger also. So we need that courage to be meek also, to self-control ourselves, then to be meek really. Then we need to controlling ourselves. Then sometimes we need that challenging or fighting, but then not like with violence, or just out of my emotional anger, but then controlling myself, but then submissive to God, but then we need to be courageous to do the will of God. So, because God is our master, sometimes God wants us to do something, something dangerous or something against the evil things, then the people who are meek, they can control themselves, but then following this will of God, yeah, this is the people who are meek. Yeah. So like Jesus, who he really followed the will of God, and then with the courage, he went to the cross, and then he was also fighting against the evil things. We want to, I hope we can be the people who can submissive and then controlling ourselves, but then obedience, yeah, with also courage, yeah, so that we can be the blessed people who can inherit the earth. So let us pray together. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time. We saw that the meek people will be blessed and they will inherit the kingdom of God. Father God, we want to be meek and we want to obey you and with self-control and tend by your word, not by our emotion or violent heart, but then as we are obeying you, we want to do your will. Father, please help us to be meek people. Use us to this work of salvation, and then through our lives we can save many souls with our meekness and our love. And please be with us and guide us. We thank you in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen.